Hold tight, man. Hold tight. I'm gonna get you out of this. Oh.
Only Paris Hilton can make tent sex sexy. Guys, welcome to another episode of Katie Afraidy. I'm your host, Katie Hettenbach, and I'm excited to have this person on. He's hilarious. He's wonderful. He's my comedy friend. He performs all over town. As
yeah,
they like
the generic intro.
All over Los Angeles.
That's right.
And other places when he wants to. But he also has a show at the Ice House in Pasadena. It's Sean Porter.
Hey, what's up, Katie? Hey, everybody. Thanks for having me.
You're welcome. What? You're welcome.
Thank you.
Period. Yeah, you're welcome. Yes. Thanks for being here. Why did I say that so aggressively? I don't know. It's fine. We're good. I just started having a hot flash, so we are crushing.
All right. Yep.
Hell absolutely. Yeah. Menopause.
So in the pocket.
Menopause. It's great. So are you a horror fan?
You know what? I don't watch much horror.
Okay.
So that's why I'm so excited to do this.
Okay.
When you hit me up, I was like, yeah, I want to do it. Because I don't watch too much of it. I don't know why. It's not because I'm like, oh my God, this is scary. I don't know. It's just because, like, I was traumatized as a very young boy by my sisters watching The Exorcist.
Okay.
Was awesome.
I've heard a lot about people.
The Exorcist is amazing.
Yeah. Oh my God.
But my older sisters are bullies.
Okay.
And so I remember watching it, and then after the movie, my sister putting on like a white gown and her hair down, almost like the Ring style.
Okay.
And she had her green mask on, like her thing.
Mm-hmm.
And she was at the end of the hallway. My older sister, Mimi, was like, she's awful.
That's pretty mean, honestly.
Yeah.
That's pretty mean.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was a great gag. I mean,
100%.
I get it. But like, yeah. No, but so I'm more of like a comic book geek, I guess.
Okay, yeah.
You know? So I was excited to do this. Like, you haven't seen this, right? You've seen this.
I've never seen the movie until...
You haven't seen this?
Yeah, until now.
Okay.
Yeah, which is why I was also, like, the majority of the podcast is also movies I've wanted to watch, but haven't had time to. And now I'm like,
yeah.
Well, now I have to, and now I have to talk about it.
Yes.
So.
And boy, do I have notes.
Oh, we got some notes. We watched 2005's The House of Wax.
House of Wax.
Which is supposed to be a remake, but it's not. It's nothing like...
I saw that. Yeah, it was
original.
Like a 1953 or something.
That's exactly it.
Right?
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, let me see if this one stars Paris Hilton, too.
No, it does not. So, fun fact about that is that everyone's like, oh, but what did they throw Paris in? Like, whatever. No, Paris was the first person to be signed on
to
that
movie.
Cast. And they built the movie
around her.
Yeah.
I almost hit you up. I almost texted you as I'm watching this. And I'm like, OMG, Paris Hilton's in this. I almost texted you. I was like, what? Okay.
Good old Paris. She did a great job throughout the whole movie, first of all. Even though her character has some pretty solid horror moments.
Yes.
That I was like, okay, you're smart. Like, what was one of the...
It was a good death. I liked the death.
Oh, the death was brilliant.
The death
was
good.
We also jump around and spoil everything. Oh, it was the first thing I wrote. Paris Hilton, smartest in the movie. The one girl goes, oh, we should follow the smell. And she's like, why? Like, yeah, when you're camping and you're like, something smells bad, we should follow that.
Right.
Yeah, maybe don't.
Let's go towards it.
Maybe don't.
That's such a horror movie trope. I was like, immediately, I was like, my first reaction was, OMG, Paris Hilton's in this. And then I was like, I hope she dies first. And then I was like, oh, no, she's actually a brilliant actor because apparently she's like hella racist and has a black boyfriend in this movie. I was like, oh, she really acted. Did you know that?
No.
Fans? Katie fans?
Allegedly.
Allegedly.
I have to keep reminding
allegedly.
Myself
do yourself
allegedly.
A favor. Do yourself a favor. Just Google Paris Hilton racist.
Huh.
So I was like, oh, she's pulling off. She got some good acting
chops.
She's
acting. But also, in general, her acting wasn't that bad. I was like,
I mean,
okay.
Compared to the rest of the cast?
Chad Michael Murray. Don't insult my boyfriend, Chad Michael Murray.
I knew it. And what happened to Lisa Cuthbert? What happened to her? Where'd she go?
Which one was, who's that? Which
the,
one was
the, that? The main
girl. Yeah. Yeah. I,
cause she was like a it girl for like a minute, all like
these,
a hot minute.
All of these, she's probably doing some Hallmark movie.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, the girl from, what's her name, from She's All That. She was in a Hallmark movie.
Yes.
And I was like, girl, you were popping.
Right.
And now you're like.
I want to say like mid-2000s, like in the aughts. Like,
yeah.
Lisa Cuthbert, she was like a thing.
Yeah.
I remember.
Yeah. It's like.
Like I first saw her in Old School. It was like, remember when he hooks up with what he thinks is the college girl.
Mm-hmm.
And she's really in high school, that whole part. And then, like, then she was, like, in Maxim. Mm-hmm. I don't know if you remember Maxim, but, like, it was, like, the Maxim magazine. Ben, do you remember Maxim?
Heard of it.
Maxim, yeah, Hot 100.
It's like, I'm aware.
Yeah. So it was, like, mid-2000s that mm-hmm. was, like, popping. And, like, she was on the covers all the time. So I'm, like, I saw her, and I was, like, where did she go?
Like, she gone.
Yeah,
she
like
gone.
You said, Hallmark Channel.
Hallmark. So I should also probably read the... Or give the people...
Oh, the synopsis?
The synopsis.
Yeah.
Sometimes I like to do it off the top of my head, but sure. I honestly don't know...
While you do that, I'm going to drink this definitely...
It's just water. It's just water. It's not anything else.
Beverage.
It's not taped. It's That's how the
this is how it comes.
Beverage
yeah,
looks. It says it's just water on it.
I picked up in Silver Lake. You know, this is what hipsters do. This is the new brand.
Silver Lake, man.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a group of teens are unwittingly... Is that a word? Stranded. They're stranded near a strange wax museum and soon must fight to survive and keep from becoming the new exhibit. That's a terrible synopsis. Honestly, a bunch of horny kids go to the woods and then their car breaks down and they decide to Scooby-Doo and split up and they discover this old, you know, abandoned town.
I have so many questions about this wax museum, too. When we get there,
yeah.
To that part.
Oh, yeah.
It's so many plot questions about this.
The first thing I want to ask you is, do you have you been to Madame Tussauds?
Yes.
That's what I want to talk about.
Okay. Yes,
and what are your thoughts about that? And
those figures look horrible.
Okay.
They look
horrible. You were like, the quality isn't
at all.
Okay.
At all. It's just like, I don't know who those artists are, but it's like a bunch of hacks just put together celebrities. No, this isn't art. This is
you
hack.
You're here first.
That I'm like, so that's even like.
Hack artists.
Yeah.
That's where the art school kids go to die.
Right. Exactly. Sell out. No, I'm looking at half these celebrities. I'm like, who? What? It's like, you know, my boy Kobe died. Like, all these murals popped up.
Mm-hmm.
And the first couple weeks, it was like, hey, that's awesome. And then, like, it kept going. I was like, okay. Like, don't even look like Kobe. Like, that looks like Tupac. That's not even Kobe. Like,
yeah.
They just start getting hackier and hackier. Like, these murals. That's how I feel like about the Wax Museum. Anyway.
So, I've learned something about myself over the course of, the past month. I watched also Five Nights at Freddy's, and I was like, why is this movie, everyone's like, this isn't scary, and I'm like, but why am I afraid? And I'm like, hey, I think you might have not a fear, but it creeps me out, mannequins and animatronics and wax figures, because when I went to Madame Tussauds, I was terrified, because I was like, I felt like they were going to move.
Right.
I was fine. I was
they
like,
they just look weird.
They
shit.
Just, it's like they don't look... Like, they look human, but they're not. It's just, it's not going to move, but it might move.
Right.
And you're like, I don't know about that.
And then, you know, those dudes on the street that, like,
oh,
like
yeah.
This
I'm like, that's...
For 9 hours. Like, that shit.
Props to them. Are they just like...
Oh, can we
they...
cuss on this?
Yeah.
Okay, we can, okay.
No, you fucking can't. No. Fuck no.
Ben's
shit
like,
balls.
It's like a clean material only.
Dick.
We don't like, yeah.
Say all say the seven words you can't say on
right.
No,
so
YouTube?
Like it starts like you know the movie starts the typical horror movie tropes,
yeah.
Right? A bunch of attractive teens go camping, and I'm like, whenever I was like, I'm usually like, okay, when I see a bunch of like attractive white teenagers going camping, it's usually like a Bible retreat,
yeah,
right? Isn't it?
Yeah.
It's like it's not it's like okay, and then Paris Hilton's the slut. Now, that's what I wanted to talk to you about, because I think it's the typical horror movie trope that is so rooted in sexism.
Oh, yeah.
That's how you know only dudes write these movies.
Yeah.
Because the slut always dies first. The slut always gets it at camp because she wants to hook up and have a good time with her boyfriend. So she deserves to die?
I will say, though.
That's like, who do we kill off? Oh, she's having teenage sex. Slut, you die.
She's
now.
Having unteenage sex.
Yeah.
No, but it's in this movie, it's
unmarried
the,
sex.
It's the boyfriend who's like, hey, we're gonna stay back. I'm gonna have sex with my girlfriend.
Right.
And then I love
immediately like
I
they're
love
both gonna
that,
die.
But they're like they're camping, and I'm like, I've been camping with a boyfriend, and I'm like, I'm like, we're not having sex. Like, we're in a tent.
There's nothing romantic about it.
We're in a tent. And she's doing this full strip tease. And I'm like, only Paris Hilton can make tent sex sexy.
Right.
I'm like, I love it. Go for it. And then she takes all of her clothes off. She's doing that strip tease. And he's like, yeah.
Also, the irony that she didn't want to be filmed on the camcorder. And she was afraid of being filmed. The irony there.
That was already written in the script, apparently, that was before they cast her. So that was, like, something that she, like, was like, no, that already happened. Or, like, okay, Paris.
Yeah. Okay, all of a sudden, you don't like the limelight in the camcorder. And you can tell this is pre-social media because everyone was like, ugh, get that camera out of my face.
Don't. Otherwise, everyone would be like, please film me.
It would be, they would go camping today and Instagram live everything.
Oh, 100%.
Every single second of it.
100%. But I love that. So she does this whole, like, striptease, and then they're like cuddly, making out, and she goes, I have something serious to tell you. I'm like, do that before you take your clothes off.
Yo, seriously. Yo, you gonna hit him with the I might be pregnant, right? Was that what she was talking about?
Was it the pregnant thing, or she just wanted
to talk? Were they talking about that? Like,
I thought it was
Lisa Cuthbert.
I thought they were talking about, like, he doesn't take me seriously. He wants the he likes the car more than her.
Who mentioned
whatever.
The pregnancy part in the beginning?
I blacked out.
But yeah,
the whole movie
don't hit me with that.
Okay, guys, PSA, if you're gonna hook up with somebody in a tent, do it, okay, safely. Mm-hmm. But also, you know, if you're gonna have a serious talk, do it before the sex.
Yes.
And have sex as like, hey, we talked. Now we get to reward ourselves with sex.
Maybe on the car ride there.
Yeah. Well, I mean, she was given roadhead on the car ride there.
Yes. Yeah. That's right. Yeah. She was really acting.
Her acting was phenomenal.
Like layers.
Dude, so good. I also want to talk about, Chad Michael Murray.
Yep.
Who plays,
That's right. He
just got out of jail or whatever. His name is Nick. And Nick and Carly, who's the main girl, are brother and sister. But when they first introduced each other, I was like, are they going to fuck? Mm-hmm. I was like...
There was definitely that tension there.
It took me so long to realize that they were siblings.
Isn't brother-sister...
No.
Rapport.
It is step-sibling porn
it
rapport.
Is, right, exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm like, just do the incest thing and kiss already, God. But everyone was saying that in the, like...
Yeah, there was. It was definitely not brother sister vibes.
Yeah. They're like, I don't know about that. I mean, it's Chad Michael Murray. He's got this sex appeal.
All right, now what happened to him? Where's he been?
In my dreams. In my dreams. I think he's also doing Hallmark.
I think
he's doing like the NCIS.
Does Ryan Gosling just take all his gigs?
I think so. Yeah, but he still does the. I just saw him on TikTok doing those. Reading thirst traps or thirst tweets.
And how's he looking today?
He's looking fine.
Still good?
He's Asian like fine wine.
Yeah, he is.
Oh. I'm like, hello. What was the one? He was reading one that was like, oh, my sexual awakening was in a Cinderella story when he licks his fingers before he throws the football. He goes like, and then throws the football. And then he's like, yeah, you have to do that if it's like, you know, to really grip it. And he's like, but I'm glad that's your sexual awakening. And then he like winked at the camera and I was like, okay, I'm pregnant. Sorry. Sorry. I love you, Chad Michael Murray. Be on the podcast.
That's your crush.
That's okay. I have many. It's okay. They're all basically generic white men.
Yeah.
That's
mine's George Clooney.
Fair enough. He's a silver fox.
That's my guy. Amazing tequila.
Amazing tequila. I don't think I've ever had his tequila.
Casamigos? You know Casamigos? You've had Casamigos before. Ben, have you tried Casamigos?
Nope. Had Terramana.
That's the Rock's tequila, right? I think Casamigos.
Casamigos. Okay.
Don't beat me up, Rock. I love you.
The Rock is gonna find you.
I know.
He knows where you live.
He knows
where you live. Also, so they go camping, whatever, and then they go, you know, separate.
Yes.
And
I feel like the beginning was like a mix between, it was like Blair Witch and Spring Break.
Yeah, I was
like the first act. Yeah. Right, where they're recording each other is like, okay, but like you're doing Blair Witch, but like it's a hot Blair Witch. I don't know.
Yeah, you're like, there's more sex involved, and like now we're gonna go camping, but also we're gonna go try to go to this football game.
Yeah.
But they never make it. So they're like, oh, fuck it. We're just going to go meet up with the others at camp.
And was where like, was the what? Football game? On the other side of the hill? So, like, they were trying to knock out two things that weekend? Like, hey, we're going to go camping.
Yeah.
I'm going to bang my girlfriend.
Yeah.
And then we're going to go to the Giants game? Because they're in New York? Like, what?
What a weird, like how do these events all...
Right.
Like, if you're gonna go to a football game, I always say camp before, you know?
Yeah.
You know camp before, and then you pregame with the camp, and then you go to the football game.
It's like the ultimate tailgate.
Yeah, I want to smell, like, campfire at the game.
Right, exactly.
Yeah, I want to just look my worst.
Right.
Yeah, anytime I go camping, and I, like, talk to my mom, or I see my mom afterwards, she goes, are you okay?
Yeah.
And I'm like, I've been in the woods for 3 days.
When's the last time you went camping? How recent?
Honestly, I think it's been 4 years.
It's been at least 15 for me.
Okay.
At least. I probably want to say I was probably late, a teenager, probably 18, 19.
Okay.
Last time
okay.
I went camping.
It's fun. I like camping.
Yeah. I like going places that has a casino.
Fair enough. I do too. I like both.
You like both? Okay. Yeah, I like both. Yeah. And I have like allergies now and shit.
Okay.
I can't, yeah.
You're like, I'm an adult.
The minute
now,
I'm rolling around in like leaves and shit, I'm like, okay, no, I can't.
You roll around in leaves and shit?
That's what you do in camping, right? Don't you like, aren't you around like foliage all the
time? I thought you meant you actually rolled around in leaves and shit.
And shit.
Yeah, I want to just double check.
Well, then that thing too, though.
That thing too. Cool.
Right?
Cool. Got it.
You shit when you go camping? No, you hold it for the 48 hours. No, or do you take a dump?
Porter potty.
They have porter potties at campsites. Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yeah, but it's just a hole in the ground. I love shit in a hole.
You love shit in the hole?
I love shit in the hole.
I did that when I was a kid. I went camping with my dad. I was like...
Hell, he reeks. Oh, but it's...
He's like, oh, because, you know, he's a Vietnam War vet. He's like, oh, I'll show you how to make a toilet. Bury the thing. I was like, all right, I ain't doing this anymore.
Yeah, but there are times when I'll be hiking and I'm like, I gotta poop. And I'm like, I could. And I'm like, and you can't wipe.
No.
And it's like, nah.
All right, yeah, suck it up.
Think about baseball.
That's it.
Baseball, cold showers.
It's all mental. It'll go away.
But they
meet the country hillbilly?
Yes, and that was what I'm talking about. So
typical horror movie trope, right? Oh. The weird country hillbilly guy.
Remind me, where are you from?
Here.
Okay. So I don't know about here, but in Wisconsin, we have something called the dead trucks.
Dad trucks?
Dead trucks.
Dead trucks.
Yeah. Do you know what that is?
No.
So it's basically where a giant truck. So you know, like the ones that pick up all the giant trucks that pick up all like the like scrap metal and furniture and stuff.
Uh-huh.
It's like that,
like junkyard
for dead animals.
Or for dead animals.
For dead animals. So like if there's like a dead deer, you'll call them and they'll come and scoop it up and put it on the truck. So it's called a... So that... I was like, it's a dead truck. That's what I... And I was like, wow.
I did not know. This is the first time I'm learning about this.
It's a dead
this.
Truck. Yeah, that's what they're called.
I did not know this.
But so I've seen many a truck that have had, you know, something dead in the back. But this truck had like... The interior was lined with like every single rabbit's foot known to man.
Right.
And just... He's never taken it to the car wash. There's just
no
blood in the back of the truck, which is
missing
great.
Teeth. His eyes is crossed like this. And I was like, oh yeah. So let's get a ride from this guy.
Yep. You're like, well, he's the only guy there. So what are you gonna do? What are you gonna do? I mean, I would walk.
Totally checks out. Yeah.
I'd walk in.
No,
the
let's
woods.
Ask him for help.
Mm-hmm. He's got a call. Hey, he seems nice.
The creepy
right?
hillbilly guy. Yeah.
Yeah. So the supernatural guy, what's his name? Jared Padalecki. I'm gonna call him just Jared.
We'll just call him Jared.
Jared. He went to Jared. Mm-hmm. He and the main girl, they go in the truck and they're like, do 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 do, and they're like, we want to get out right now. So they get out. And
that was her boyfriend in,
that
the,
was her,
in the movie.
That,
right?
You tell me. I thought her. I thought Chad Michael Murray was her boyfriend.
Right,
at this
exactly.
Rate.
I know.
Like,
yeah, yeah.
Sibling, 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 sibling.
Right, 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 right. No, that was her boyfriend. And I remember he kept egging her on to go, oh, let's go check this out. Oh, let's go walk over here. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, oh, yeah, he's dead.
He's 100%. And
he's so dead.
And they walk into this town. And it's
horrible,
like,
haircut, too, by the way.
But it's very 2000. It's very 2005.
It's very 2000 something. Yes.
2005.
Yes,
it's very
yes,
2005.
It is, totally.
And like they walk into the place and they're like, everything's like lit up. Everything's like, you know, they got puppies in the window and she's like, oh my God, puppies.
Right.
And then they interrupt a funeral real quick.
I actually wrote that down.
So
I
funny.
I said the best line I've heard in a long time. You walk in on a funeral for a fucking fan belt. That's genius. That's the funniest line I've ever heard.
Comedy.
Comedy.
Comedy right there.
Like bars.
So good. So good.
I was like, what?
And then they're like, what would he say after that? And then I think they went back to the guy's house or whatever, which was like down the street. And
right.
The girl's like, I'll just wait in the car because the boyfriend had to pee, but he never comes back.
Mm-hmm.
And then the girlfriend's like, wait, something's off. And then turns out the funeral guy, oh my God, we missed the best part. The beginning, the opening. Do you remember the
yes,
opening?
Yes, let's go. Yes, let's go
oh
back
my God.
To the very beginning. Rewind.
It's part of the process of the podcast. It's chaos. It's always chaos.
The beginning. I was like, okay, typical horror movie origin story.
Yeah, you got
parental abuse.
Parental abuse. You got one sibling being the angel child, the other
yep.
sibling being like strapped down,
yes,
you know, biting, drawing blood from the mom, and the mom's trying to make this mask.
Make a wax
mask
at the same time.
And it's just
and
chaos.
They strap down their unruly child and torture him. And I'm like, okay, so set up why this guy is a serial killer. Okay, victim of parental abuse. I'm like, all right, I got my ass whooped growing up as a kid.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we don't turn out to be serial killers. I'm like, you're trying to rationalize why this guy's going to murder
yeah.
a whole town. Okay, it's like
yeah, it's and then so but then
as she's making wax figures,
she's yeah. So now we're going back to where we were.
Yes.
So
that's like the very opening scene, right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And you're like, what the fuck is this? I was like, what is this movie?
Because
mm-hmm. I've heard people either love this movie or hate it.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, what am I getting?
It's very 2005.
Oh, it's so 2005. It's great.
It's in like a time. Time capsule, like that is, yeah.
Oh,
very 2005.
The moment you
it had
see,
everything. It had
the,
Paris Hilton. It had everything.
The moment you see Paris Hilton in her like yeah. blue tracksuit, I'm like,
that's it.
Yes.
Right. Exactly.
Yes. More of that.
Mm-hmm.
More tracksuits, which they're coming back. They're coming back.
They are coming.
Which is great. I do own one. I love wearing
the
it.
The juicy on the ass.
I have a Nike one.
Yeah.
That's a brown velour.
Yeah, brown velour.
That's what I used to wear when I was little.
Comfortable.
So I was like, let's go. Oh, mm-hmm. It's good. But the funeral guy, his brother. So
that's
the
brother.
Two siblings from the beginning.
Right.
There's so many siblings. Siblings.
Right.
The incest siblings, as we'll call them. That's Chad Michael Murray and the main character.
Right.
And then these are the killer siblings.
Yes.
The guy who you're like, oh, this is the crazy kid from the beginning, is now turning our supernatural guy, Jared,
mm-hmm.
into
the boyfriend, yeah,
into wax. And they like, he injects him with stuff. And honestly, that's to me is terrifying.
Okay, and that, but also I'm watching that scene and I'm like, the science behind this. Where did he study this? Like, where did he, like, that looked like he had to go to some type of vocational training.
Yeah.
To concoct this elaborate machine. I'm like, where did this guy study this from?
Where are you getting this stuff from, also? Like, where?
And where are you getting this stuff?
I mean, because.
This is all left behind from his mom?
Because then you realize that, you know, throughout the movie that the entire town is wax.
Right.
So he's obviously had a lot of practice.
Right, exactly. With, you know, a lot of practice. A
lot of practice with, like, making people into wax.
Did he build these machines himself? Were they left over?
Like, we don't know. We don't know how that happened. But it's just, it's fascinating that he, like, I don't know. It's so disturbing, too. Like, it's so disturbing to imagine, like, you can't do anything and someone's just like, okay, I'm just going to strap you up to these things and I'm just going to cover you in wax.
I'm going to coat you in wax.
And then you're going to live out your entire life.
And didn't he, like, inject them?
Yeah, I think he, like, paralyzed them, basically.
To paralyze them?
Yeah.
And then did that. See, so that, because I'm like, okay, so this is a ghost town they're walking into, yet there's a funeral happening?
Yeah.
Where do these people come from?
You're like, what the hell is that? And then you realize that later in the movie,
right,
that they're all wax.
Right.
Everyone is wax.
Right.
And it's actually a funeral for the mom permanently.
So oh, it's like, for the mom.
So that's the mom's
okay.
real dead body. And everyone else in the town is like old hitchhikers.
Okay.
That they would
so
pull.
Did the mom just die? Or are they reenacting the mom's funeral?
She's been dead for okay. a minute. But they just permanently have a funeral going on for her because they have such mommy issues.
Obviously.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Where was dad?
I don't know where dad went.
I'm a single mother. I got this wax gig. I got a shithead son. I don't have time to talk to him. So I'm just going to strap him up to a fucking chair.
Yep.
And torture him and abuse him.
Yes.
You're a good kid, this one.
You're fine.
I don't have time. I'm working here as I'm trying to make you pancakes.
What is wrong with you? And then you're gonna freaking like try to scratch me and draw blood? Also, right. How sharp are these kids' fucking nails?
Right, exactly.
Jesus Christ.
Because they're 5, 6 at that point?
They're in high chairs.
They're in high chairs, right.
You're
so toddler, a little older than the toddler?
Damn, these are some aggressive toddlers.
Some shitty kid. Listen.
I've babysat before, but I've never had a kid like scratch me like that.
No.
Or like, I don't know, these kids are superhuman.
That's what
kids.
Boarding school is for. Just ship this little kid to boarding school.
Ship the kid off. Just hey, both the kids deserve, you know, to get some help.
Right.
And I want that for them. But unfortunately that wouldn't be a horror movie.
Your child might be you know, autistic. I don't know. Maybe some meds would help.
That'd be good. Oh, also, so how he got the boyfriend to be like, you know, disarmed is they got him by the Achilles.
That's right.
And that's the majority of the movie that I was like, is that constantly they were going for the jabbing
for
the
me,
feet.
I totally agree. That's the one thing that I cringed at the entire movie mm-hmm. when I saw the Achilles get, you know,
yeah.
slit.
And then that happened again when Paris, when she was, you know, being chased by the killer.
Mm-hmm.
She makes her way into town and into this, like, warehouse. And, of course, she's just wearing a T-shirt, bra, mm-hmm. and underwear, because, of course. But she's, like, running through, trying to find. But they just keep fucking jabbing her in the
right.
foot. And I'm just like, girl, no. But honestly, I was rooting for her, but then I saw her be stupid in that warehouse. And I was like, she's like hiding behind like a pole. Just
right.
Like that. And you're like, hey, he can see you. He can see you.
Every horror movie that involves camping and a forest,
mm-hmm.
doesn't it also require like idiots too? It
oh, yeah.
requires some stupidity for yep. you to die. By an axe murderer, right?
Yeah, and she died. They put she had a pipe, which I was like, okay.
Yeah.
Finally, you're going to run around with something sharp. Awesome. And then she drops it. Of course she does.
Of course she does.
Yeah. And then he fucking jabs the wax guy, javelins it just right through her head.
That was a pretty dope death.
I was like, dude, put this guy on the fucking Olympics.
Right. That was actually a pretty good throw.
That was a really good shot. RIP Paris, but like, dude, that was a sick shot.
Like this guy was an athlete, obviously. Yeah. I don't know why he took this life of murdering towns.
Dude, if he just put his energy, the same energy that with the wax figures into this,
right.
Dude, his life would be so different.
He murked an entire town of people. You are qualified to do a lot greater things if you just, you know what I mean? It's like that ability to do that. You should work for NASA. Like, you shouldn't be.
But he's like, I want to be an artist. But I want. He's like, I want
to
be.
Yeah, was that the agenda? He was trying to be an artist like his mom. What was the motive?
But then why was he? Maybe he just was lonely and wanted people to stay, because his mom didn't like want him, or whatever.
Because his mom rejected him. But then his brother was talking about, we're going to live out mom's dream. Or he says something like that. I think his brother was encouraging him.
I think his brother. So what I got from the ending is, what was it? Bo and, what was the other brother's name? Bo
Victor.
And, wait, no. Bo. No. So, yeah.
Wasn't it Victor or something like that?
I think
Vincent?
So. Oh, Vincent and Bo. Yeah. So, but they're played by the same actor. Mm. So, I believe that Bo, who's the one running around with everybody else,
right.
I think he was the one in the chair. He was the crazy one. We just assume because, this guy's disfigured,
right.
that is. But I think it was the opposite. And I think Bo made Vincent.
I think you're giving the screenwriters too much credit.
Probably. But then it also, they reveal, there's a third brother. And who's the third brother?
Yeah, the creepy hillbilly
guy.
The guy in the
fucking dead truck.
Okay, so that their entire mansion that they lived in.
Wax.
Was made of wax.
Which, so wild.
Okay, does the science and the engineering stand up to that? Kid, you live in an entire fucking castle full of wax, and it still hold up firmly, like foundation and everything.
Yeah. And it's in Louisiana.
right. Or I thought it was supposed to be upstate New York or some shit.
I think it's in Louisiana. It's like Louisiana, yeah.
And I was like, oh no, I know the WB lot when I see it. I saw the the whole thing sits on fire, and then this was this like massive hellscape pit. I'm like, wait a second. This entire thing was built of wax? Who took the time to do that? Vincent?
They got time on their hands. They said
he should win a Nobel Peace Prize. That's how brilliant a mind he is.
Honestly,
if he was able to set this entire operation up.
Fair enough, dude. He deserves a lot more credit than he was given.
That's what I'm saying.
He's pretty good. You're like, damn,
yo,
dude.
You're using your powers. Like, no. What are you doing?
You deserve more.
Right.
Vincent, you deserve more. Bo's just mistreating
you. Fucking mommy issues.
Mommy issues will be the...
They
will kill you. Right. They will kill you. But
mommy issues. Man. Yeah, so that was like, okay, that's wild.
That was wild. And also, when the incest siblings, if you will, when they found... Jared Supernatural, the boyfriend at the piano, like covered in wax.
Right.
No, it wasn't him. It was the one friend.
Oh, it was the
friend with the camcorder.
Yeah.
He's like, I'm going to get you out of there. And
starts peeling his face.
And he's like, I'm going to help you. I'm like, that's his skin now. Like, skin.
Yeah, you peeled his face cheek
it's
off.
It's not.
Why are you continuing to do that?
Because he's like, maybe this will help. It's like, no, it's not. And honestly, at this point, kill him. Like, shoot him. That's how you're going to help him, is you're going to kill him. Because
have you ever helped anyone ever? Even if, like,
period.
Say I had
no.
something on, period.
No.
Even if you had something on, like, my face.
Okay.
Have you ever helped somebody by scratching their fucking, clawing their face like a fucking cat?
No.
Let
me help you real quick. Let me just get that. Again, sharp nails. Everybody.
Everybody.
The moral of the story is get a fucking nail clipper. Get a nail clipper.
Oh, real quick. Cool scenes. Yeah. I thought the movie scene when they're in the movie theater.
Yes.
And he's like double barrel shotgun and like blowing the people's heads off and shit.
Yes.
The wax, the thing exploding. That was pretty cool. Elisa Cuthbert taking a bat to the brother's face
at the very end. That was really good.
That was good.
I also Elisa, she gets taken by Bo and like strapped
right.
up or whatever, and
for his brother to his do brother, his thing,
yeah,
right,
and he like glues her mouth shut, and apparently right. that was real. That she actually glued her mouth shut with real super glue.
Oh, all of a sudden we're going to be method?
Method.
In this fucking campy-ass horror film? Now that's when you want to go method?
The majority of it was practical effects, too.
That I appreciate that.
Which is
I like practical effects.
Oh, the ending scene was phenomenal because of
yeah,
that.
Yeah, because of
it.
Yeah.
But, so she did that, and she was like trying to, you know, get...
And then they chop her finger off.
Because she tries to, you know, get her
right.
brother slash lover's attention. And obviously, you know, they escape, whatever. And I love that they're like, oh, we need to go. Oh, there's a weapon store. We should go in there. We should just break in. And the first thing that Chad Michael Murray goes for is a crossbow. He's like, I know how to use a crossbow. It's yeah. like, okay, crossbows are like. Kind of complicated. You have to like,
yes.
and they're hard to use. It's not like a
actually,
fat...
you have to train to learn how to use them and
yeah,
shoot
they're
them
not,
accurately.
They're not easy.
Yeah.
And he's like, oh, I got it. And also, like, what? Yeah. And it just has unlimited arrows. And I'm like, dude, what kind of crossbow is this? I need that crossbow.
He's just Hawkeye all of a sudden, yeah.
But then this is my problem in every single horror movie. They stab somebody and then they leave the weapon.
Right.
On the ground and just start running. I'm like, you're right. just assuming that wherever you're going next is going to have something else.
Exactly.
Nope, keep it with you. Just run with it.
I'd be like, Katie, is he dead yet? Is he dead? Did you see him? Okay.
Double check. We're going to
check it
real
quick.
We're going to double check.
Yes.
We're going to slit his throat and
right.
cut off his head
yeah.
and kick it into the woods.
Right. And then,
and then
we could,
shit
yes.
on it and then run. Dig a big shit in it and then go.
Right.
Just to really make sure and then dump it in the lake. No, you shouldn't dump it in the lake because then they always come back.
No, because they come back. Right.
They come back. Then. You know.
Oh, you know, I was one thing I was disappointed about. No jump scares in this movie.
Yeah, not really.
There are no jump scares. There was no where you know the close up, the you know front close up here, and then the turn, and then the monster right there. There was none of that in
yeah.
this movie. That's what I'm saying. It was very 2005. It was very mid 2000s.
But I think it's perfect. Honestly,
yeah.
I love this movie.
You did. You loved.
I loved it. I changed like if you. Look at my notes mm-hmm. in my notebook. I took a picture of it, though, so I wasn't actually holding it. I changed the rating six different times because I was like, no, did I like it? And when I thought about it, I was like, you know what? This was so fun. It's campy.
Mm-hmm.
It's silly. But also, like, the practical effects and, like, that last scene.
The third act, the
so
last scene.
So good.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, was I scared? I'm like, you know what? You were, because the Achilles thing, because,
mm-hmm.
you know, you're like, Paris, come on.
The torture
on.
Thing with the wax and the
yeah.
guy. Yeah.
That's
with
terrifying. And
stuff.
I think it did what it needed to do.
Yeah.
Was it silly? Of course.
Right.
But I think it did a pretty damn good job, and I liked it a lot.
I think Vincent had a lot of potential. That is
yeah.
a massive. He murks an entire town. He builds this very complicated wax torturing mechanism because mom like I don't
because
know
because mom
yeah.
yeah
I thought it was very yeah like time capsule-y. It was fun, right? It had its moments. It was very Paris Hilton. I didn't know that she was the first one cast.
Oh yeah
because this is right prime Paris Hilton.
Oh, the best.
Amazing acting chops,
so good. The fun fact, I'm going to give you some
yes,
fun
please.
Facts
yeah,
now.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Alicia.
Is
Alicia?
I thought it was Elisa Cuthbert.
It's spelled,
sorry.
It's spelled like Alicia, but with an E.
Oh.
Yes. So she kept getting stuck repeatedly in the melting wax bed while filming the final scenes on the movie. But fun fact, the wax was actually peanut butter.
Okay.
Now you know.
How about if he was covering people in peanut butter.
He's torturing. Like, he's like the one. Have you seen that?
His mom was a peanut farmer, and
dude, that would suck if you were allergic to peanuts. That would suck.
Just taking out kids with peanut allergies. Just wipes.
You target kids with peanut allergies.
Just 14-year-olds, 13-year-olds just go missing.
Why? Everywhere. Why are they all kids? Do adults have peanut allergies still? Is that a thing? I know that they do, but I haven't met. It's like meeting an adult who's like, I have an Audi belly button. I'm like,
right.
Like, I know you exist, but like,
right, exactly.
Where are you?
Yeah, no, I have not.
Comment down below one. If you're an Audi belly button / have a peanut allergy. But no, it's if he was gonna do peanut butter. Have you seen that one video of the baby covered in peanut butter where he just goes, eh?
No.
It's so good. He's eh. Does it feel good?
I feel like the studio head. I feel like Vincent was obviously Leatherface.
Oh yeah.
I feel like the studio heads were like, all right. Leatherface meet Waxface.
Mm-hmm.
Meeting adjourned. Let's do blow. You know what I mean? That's how easy that is.
Yeah, the whole time I was like,
and let's get Paris Hilton.
Paris Hilton, bring her in. We got babes. Bring them in. I also like when they brought everybody down to his like lair.
Yeah.
They kept flashing this cauldron.
Right.
And I was like, okay, well, you know, I know a lot about serial killers. Who has a cauldron?
Right.
Ed Gein. Ed Gein is known for his cauldron.
Oh, okay.
That he would, you know, get people, you know, and, you know, a little, and, you know.
Also, that's what I'm saying. That is very heavy equipment that he had in the basement.
He's jacked.
That stays up, that the wax foundation holds up.
Dude.
The wax, because all it took was a little bit of fire.
But also.
And everything started melting.
Also, there's already fire in there, and it's like,
and there's already fire in there, and this whole thing's made of wax.
I don't understand, but hey, you know what?
Yeah,
I'll let it happen. It's like the in the newer Willy Wonka. They're like, oh, we're gonna have this entire palace made out of chocolate, and then it's like on one really hot day, it starts to melt. It's like it's really hot in Louisiana, like all the time. So like,
that's a lot of. You know, keeping up the foundation every day. I'm sure they're just every day trying to.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I feel like it'd be.
I mean, I know that Vincent doesn't sleep. How are you going to sleep? You turn the entire town into a wax museum. That's a lot of work. There's only 24 hours in the day.
He's a busy man.
You know, he was a very busy man.
He needs to take some time for himself. You know, like, hey, I know your hobby is your passion, and like, this is what you want to do.
Oh, and then they took his mask off, and his face is half gone. Were they Siamese twins? Remember we saw those little photos?
Yeah.
Were they Siamese twins and they separated them and that's why his face is disfigured like that?
I don't know, maybe.
Right?
It's like,
they were, right? Because they had this whole Siamese twins thing when she was rummaging through the place.
Yeah, and then they had.
And there's a little photo.
And then they had the two twins when the main girl was running upstairs. She like locked herself in the. Mm-hmm. Bedroom and in a crib they were like conjoined and then he slices through them
right
and I was like
okay, right
you're like literally so showing us that that's what happened. Man, I didn't actually think about that till now.
There
yeah.
should be a director's cut. I feel like there's a lot left
there's
on the table.
There's gotta be special features. I have to get it this
right
but this movie was so good. Yeah, I liked it.
It was entertaining.
So out of 10, what do you think?
I'm going to give it a 6.5.
Six and a half.
What? How about you?
7. I gave it a 7. I went 5. Mm-hmm. And I was like, no, I think it needs more than a 5.
LA 7 or Wisconsin 7? LA 7, Wisconsin 4.
Wisconsin 4. Honestly, I thought it was great.
It's, yeah.
7 just, 7 worldwide.
7 worldwide, gotcha.
A worldwide 7.
Yeah.
A worldwide 7.
International 7.
People hate this movie.
Yeah.
They hate it. They think it's terrible.
Why, because of the Paris Hilton thing?
No, they just think
you're watching a fucking campy horror film. Like, why get mad?
What more could you want? Like, sure, it has its moments, but like, it's fun.
Here's a question I always ask when I watch these movies, like back in the day. Like, who made it out of this movie? Who still has a career? Out of everyone you saw in this movie.
The guy from Supernatural probably is probably the...
He's still working?
I think so. I mean, I think they're all still working. It's just a matter of, like, what...
Hallmark Channel.
Yeah, Hallmark Channel, which is... I mean, that's still working. You can make a good living off of that. They make...
I mean, I just saw Paris Hilton in a commercial.
Oh, no, she's doing fine. I saw her a year ago. She was...
She'll forever do fine.
She's a DJ. She's...
Yeah, she DJs. Like I said, Google it. I'm telling you.
Uh-oh.
I know. It's wild.
Yikes. So... Sean, thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you for having me. This is fun. We're done already, Ben?
I know. We just feel like we just got started.
Real quick, just remind us your favorite horror film.
My favorite horror movie is Scream.
Scream.
Hands down. Yeah. How about you?
Top to bottom, Scream's of the fantastic movie. From start to finish. It was one of those like perfect magic. Everything just stars aligned. I think The Exorcist is the greatest horror movie of all time.
It's so good.
It's a masterpiece. It's art. I think it was filmed back in the 70s then, where it was like all of those directors were going out there and just making fantastic art.
It's perfect. It's terrifying.
Yeah.
And it's a good movie. And I've realized this over the time in the course of, you know, almost 100 episodes, that every horror movie is good in its own way. Yeah. Even if it's bad, it's good.
It's good.
And I've realized that, like,
I love awesomely bad movies. Yeah. I do, all the time.
When I first started, I was like, this movie sucks. Oh my God. I was so critical. And then one movie changed it all.
The Scream?
No. Santa Jaws.
Santa Jaws?
Changed my perspective on everything, because
you gotta send me this. You got the hook. I gotta watch this.
It's not good. Santa Jaws? It's not good.
I know it's not good. Santa Jaws is not good, but I had to watch this.
But it had so many fun moments that I'm like, that's what makes it good. That's what makes it good. That it's fun to watch.
Yeah.
And I think that's like the important thing. Is it fun to watch? Even if it's not a good movie, was it fun?
Is this your favorite Chad Michael Murray
movie?
Chad Michael Murray movie.
Cinderella's story is pretty good.
Okay.
You know, I don't know. I need to see more of his movies, but I just watched another one for Halloween. We did 31 Days of Horror, and I forget what movie he was in, but he was a hot dad, and I was like, okay, Sean Michael Murray. I was like, you still got it for you.
Yeah.
He hasn't lost it, but, you know, good for him. But, yeah. So this is the time of the show where you plug your shit.
Oh, yes. You can see me every month at the Ice House, Sean Porter and Friends. We do it every second Saturday of the month. This next one's coming up is December 9th. And catch me on Instagram. I'm looking here, right?
Anywhere you
want. At I am Sean Porter on Instagram, S-E-A-N. That's it.
Hell yeah.
Thanks for having me.
Thanks for being awesome. Here.
Appreciate you.
I appreciate you, and we appreciate Fangoria, because you're the best.
Water.
And it's just water. Also, wanted to say thank you to our sponsor, Filmcraft Studio Gear. You can find them at FilmcraftLA on Instagram or on FilmcraftLA.com. Also, guys, I always keep forgetting, please subscribe. Please subscribe. Please like, follow. Follow Sean. Follow
thank
us.
You.
We love you. We're on Twitter. We're on TikTok. We're on YouTube, Instagram, all that jazz at Katie Afraidy. You know, all that fun stuff. And then I like to close out the show with some really shitty advice.
Yes, I love this. Yes.
About the movie. I guess if you're going to a football game and you're like, hey, we should stop in camp. How about don't? You know what I'm saying? How about you don't? And then if you do, maybe don't ask for directions from a guy who has blood in the back of his car. Just a thought. Or do it. Up to you. You're your own person and free will exists. But at this point, maybe it shouldn't, you know?
Yes.
And on that note, guys, stay spooky and we'll see you next time.